drive is hot and spicy.
Cause when we be out, girl is pulling me out. You wouldn't believe how we wild. Turn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's burned out. Act up from northwest, east side.
Everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Let's get into it, yeah. Get stoned,
come on.
Get started,
come on.
Get started,
get started.
Let's get it started.
Ha!
Let's get it started.
Ha!
Let's get it started.
Ha!
Let's get it started. Yeah, let's get it started.
I can't rap, I just don't know the words.
Let's get it started, yeah, yeah.
Lose control of my soul. Don't move too fast, people just take it slow. Don't get ahead, just jump into it. I hear about it.
Oh, I'm just gonna party by myself tonight. I'm just gonna party by myself.
Like an infant new kid, inch by inch with a new solution. Transmit hits with no delusion.
I'm just gonna party by myself. Hey, is everybody still tuned in? Is anybody still here? Let me know. Hello? Hello? Huh?
Let's get it started.
You know, I don't ever stop talking about let's get it started. I'm playing the wrong song. Hold up, hold up. You know what? I'm playing too much. Huh? I like this video. I like her urns, but they're not bamboo. I like this video. They're all upside down and everything. You should see them.
Just bob your head like me, Apple D. Up inside your club or in your Bentley. Get messy, loud and sick. Yo, my past no more than another head trip. So come down now, do not correct it. Let's get ignorant, let's get hectic.
Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned,
come on,
get started,
come on,
get started,
get started.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started, yeah. Let's get it started.
Ha!
Let's get it started, yeah. Let's get it started.
Ha!
Let's get it started, yeah. Let's get it started.
Ha!
Let's get it started, yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
They are jamming. They are jamming.
And running.
All right, enough of that. So, I've got a lot of music. I've got a lot of stuff going on over here, people. Coming up, I will be playing the SNL podcast. We've got Nico Williams interview. Follow the funny. Okay, and that's some guy named Jay. Now, I'm going to tell you about some guy named Jay. Some guy named Jay, he's actually a figment of my imagination, okay? So when y'all see him out there, you know, y'all be nice to him now, all right? And humor him. Because you'll be humoring me. Okay, anyway, y'all know I'm crazy. So, going to go over here, and we have been really fortunate to be listening to the music of South Coast Records. South Coast Records in the house, everybody. My goodness, I always say it wrong. Some Yashu Cubby, yes, I got it right. Okay, and then some Kasha Yuppie, yes, Jay Fresco, Wes Music. Who else have I forgotten? And if I ain't got them, they will be there. So they've been on the show recently too, interviewing. We've been playing their music, and now all their music from South Coast Records and more, and everybody else from there too, is in the general rotation. And not only is it in the general rotation, it is going to be the mainstay of the rotation. South Coast Records is in full effect on Vibes Live. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Clap your hands, clap your hands. And it's some awesome, awesome music. I've just been really, really enjoying myself, and I've been really, really blessed. And so that's kind of where this guy, some guy named Jay, that's where he kind of showed up. And he's really, I'm telling you guys, he's a figment of my imagination. So let's listen to Helen of Troy, Jay Fresco, okay? And we're going to listen to some other videos and stuff like that. And then I'm going to slip in that interview, the SNL podcast, interspersed with whatever. So we're going to have a nice, well-rounded, entertainmental kind of show tonight with music and motivational stuff and just whatever. And now if I mess around and go to sleep, don't say nothing, because I've been here for quite some time. If you're lucky, I'll put on a playlist before I go. But anyway, so I got some big announcements and stuff too, and I'm going to try to get those posted up for you guys too. So stay tuned, and thank you for keeping the vibes live.
Remember the first time I saw my Helen of Troy? She entranced me with her eyes through a spelling book. We was about to run a 5-on-5. I had to put it on pause, cause shorty had, I'm trying to get in the drawers. She got out of whip slowly, she seen me approach and got to smiling, cause she knew she had a nigga open. Introductions made her lay a kiss on her hand. My homeboys get the clown and pop a shit to the mirrors. It's all good. Shorty let me know she impressed, grabbed a hold of my hand and said, walk in the brush. Now we walking and talking. She get to telling me that she got a man, but she swears she feeling me. No stress, and I don't ask what his name is. I figure he your name, kid, and now you ready, game this girl. I wasn't trying to change the world, just give her injections, sublime affections. I give her the number, not expecting a call. To my surprise, she hit me the same night. Oh, I run quick to get a bottle, get it popping at the crib. Break up some blood, cause I got a couple else to twist. When shorty got to the crib, she looked so amazing. Walked in like it was her house, she started blazing. Rocking a black dress, pumps in the sash, with a split down the back to the crack of her ass. Hair in the run, look damn near professional. Started telling me shit like we in a confessional. It's kinda hard, I don't usually find this. For 2.5 more hours, we had mind sex. Mind connected till she broke for the door. I run and stop a light, shorty, what you waiting for? She say it only take a minute to fall. Head over heels and the way that she feel, it's a little too ill. I felt the same, yo, it actually threw me. Situations like this only happen in movies. The next scene is show me deep in the booty. But we exit out the story, cause shorty, she ain't an OG. Now here's the part where the turning point start. A ringtone blaring to me in my dream apart. Shorty snoring, now I hear it ignoring. 10 seconds ringing off the hook once more. Now I'm extra Aggie when it's early in the day. About to chuck shorty's phone for a peep display. Got the trippin' when I seen what it say. This nigga Kush from Flatbush, he known for turning niggas to mush. This is not your average nigga, hard body to the core. I almost contemplated kicking shorty out the door. Fucking with his bird and just declared war. Won it all, honesty, I ain't prepared for. Shorty grabs the phone, she started to pretend like she was up late night getting drunk with her friends. And she was oh so concerned about scratching the biz. She spent the night over there with them. Right. This nigga slick, he said, aight, bitch, three ways. Started calling her friend crib to see what she say. Shorty praying that she don't pick up. She heard it low and got the drippin' like, now we fuck. Cause the story ain't fit, the GPS equipped. Whip shorty drive, choke the nigga in a split. Second where we was, now we coming with the quick alert. The whole clique shit's about to get thick with. Burn his eclipse, two for each hit. Bring out the diesel shits to make the street eclipse when it's ringing. And please, I need it with the swift. It's more than 10 minutes, I'ma need you to sit. Don't forget the extra clips, then click, check my supplies. Jam the elevator, now they got a ground five. Shorty spreading, get to me, load up the weaponry. Pause, shorty start flipping out next to me. Try to hit me, shorty with ease, she wanna leave. I say it, bounce if you want, but she meant with me. Is this love, is it lust, is it real enough for us to get it? It is, but they can make a couple for us. I never bleed from a nigga that bleed the same way I bleed, the same way I breathe is in his lungs. When he come, girl, you sleeping with me. You wanna run where I'm from, we don't play that. I shouldn't have to say that. I paint a picture for ya, the words is like a brush. The lyrics and the flow is the color, the right touch. I make a masterpiece out of easel, call it my venue. For this one here though, it gotta be continued.
Okay, you guys know that, here we go, he dropped something today on iTunes. Let me go back here. Yeah, here we go. Oh, what is this?
Rock Talk Radio.
This is a show? Oh, I found an interview. I'm gonna play it. He was here last night. This is a treat for me. I'm gonna put my feet up. This is an accident. This is his interview last night for Blog Talk. Or maybe today it was. Fresco Friday with South Coast Records. Jay Fresco's album release show with DJ Ice. I missed it. There we go. That's hot right there.
This game with the purple side and the thick rim. Shorty that can work it out. She make it clap to the beat.
Oh man, hold up. Hold up. You know what? They cut your music. I can't do you like that. So you know what? Because we played the whole song. And matter of fact, Vibes Live, we did a whole exclusive on them. Look, we called him up. We treated him so nice with class. He came on there and right on time, too. I'm going to have you know. And we did the interview. And it was short and sweet and curt. And then Vibes Live played the rest of his music that I had. And we put it in a nice little package and sent it on off. Surely did. So Vibes Live exclusive. Up on, if you go on the speaker account, speaker. You can see that. But, as I was saying, his album release with DJ Ice. Where is it called? There we go. Oh, it's available on iTunes. If you go to the Facebook page, they got a download link where you can go and download it. Yeah, that's hot. Oh, and want to give a shout out to is it Edward Collado? I ain't even gonna say it right. But Edward, he was actually the first one to purchase it. Okay, so don't y'all be the last. Matter of fact, there shouldn't be no last one. Okay, anyway, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go back to where I was. I have a very difficult time sometimes at the end of the day. I go to play stuff, and I have everything in mind, and I sit down to go and do it, and then everything goes out the window. Oh, but I know what I am going to do. Today is Brian Kotcher of Clean Cut Productions. He has a show. I'm tired, so I'm stumbling over the words. He has a song that is a Christmas song, and it's in a contest, and today's the last day of the contest, but I'm going to play it for us now.
Snowflakes and icy
dough. Superfond.
Superfond got that product show. Christmas on its way, Tagger, Rolex, jewelry show. Snowflakes and icy dough. Superfond got that product show. Christmas on its way, Tagger, Rolex, jewelry show.
Sitting home when I'm working. Yeah, I don't want to hear that.
Cash America, Super Bond. Holiday excitement, like you need a bond. Jewelry tools, music instruments, electronics, and we need your fingerprint. Just kidding. Ho, ho, ho. Go necklace, diamond rings. Yeah, we buy that. Sit down on the mat. 38 satisfaction. Yeah, we guaranteeing that. Shake your hand, see my smile. That's for the day that you're coming back. I'm at the training, internal pricing, merchandising, exercise the thought of communication. Oh, no stereo, you'll be listening. Research tools show you how we value. Put the right price on, whether it's old or new. Here we go again, customers are so cool.
Icicle. Ask us.
Where you going today?
That's Brian Kotcher.
America, walking credit card to pay. It's 10% down before you lay away. Expedition when you walk away.
That's Brian.
Snowflakes
and icicles. We gonna win this one. Are you still Brian? Brian! Brian, you need to call me and tell me what's happening with this. Let me see, what number can I have you call me on? What number is on? Brian, I'm going to call you. Answer the phone. I'm going to call you, Brian. That's what I'm going to do. I'm pointing and clicking right now. So hold up. Hold up. Wait. All right. So let's go back here. I need a playlist. Oh, so what do I want to hear? You know what? We're going to play some Kotcher Yuppie. Yeah. Hey. Hey, I'm gonna ask a question.
You got my heartbeat racing. Can't move, I'm feeling wasted.
Trip, don't blow my eye. Feeling myself, I ain't never turn up. body will turn up. She cold, that's why I burn up. We OD, I'm OZ, that OG Cali good. One thing I know, OG, smoke O, stay G. Decorating her independent, regulating she been with women. When you gone, you can't tell the difference. I feel at home, but this way I'm living. Rolling Stone, yeah, I'm tripping. Stay chill, I kick back. Lay low, give my all the talent. You just knew I did that. Lost my foreigners, caught up in euphoria. Blazing till I'm Asian, with temptations of Caucasian. This life is living it up, I stay down, sedated. Live life, not giving a fuck, young, rich, and famous. So far gone, not far from home. I'm so broke, forgot where I'm going. She got me the trip, I'm off in my zone. Maybe she will, cause if I'm about to shoot on.
You got my heartbeat racing. Can't move, I'm feeling wasted. Got me tripping, I'm dragging, chasing. So high, fly by spaceship.
Just one minute,
I get crazy, cause you were
just one love.
Your stuff to me is pretty cool. I try to open my eyes, but seeing's difficult. I can't feel my face, but I feel invincible.
Can you relate to the way that I feel? How do you dream, making it real? Pass me a Sprite,
making it trill.
Like Mary Jane, I pop me a pill. Emotions are flowing, I'm out in the open. Can you not see? She offered to show it.
Slowing it down.
Stalling the moment. Just trying to move forward. Not trying to be flawed. That's when she got lower.
And lower.
She back up on the upper. What's up, up? Put your thumbs up if you toast up. That gotcha. Blow trees, roll up. Hold up, I'm faded, it's cool. She wasted, not down for the team, you crazy. Still fuck you, pay me. Hold up, I'm faded, it's cool. She wasted, not down for my goddamn team. That's fucking crazy. So far gone, not far from home. I'm so broke, forgot where I'm going. She got me the trip, I'm off in my zone. Maybe she will, can get my fucking shit on. Crazy.
You got my heartbeat racing. Can't move, I'm feeling wasted. Got me tripping, I'm dragging, chasing. So high, fly by spaceship.
Just one minute,
I get crazy, cause you were
just one love.
Your stuff to me is pretty cool. I try to open my eyes, but seeing's difficult. I can't feel my face, but I feel invisible.
Hosting is a click, a scroll, a touch.
It's hold strange. On, I can skip the pod now. Uh-oh. Someone call 911, I'm choking. Help!
Sound like a swag side. She got ass and blow like a bagpipe. Oh, it's smash night. first, but your past life. I had an anti-type of crushes, even though you damn lie. I'm not one to hide expressions. Don't hold back, take shots. Don't bet with the glass on live. It's pop off the bottles pop. Get live, it's party ride. Party hard, the crew love it. She left for the party song. Only thing she felt was nothing. At the club and she still bumping. When we dream and then we
live. Yeah, watch what I'm gonna do. Watch this. That's just brilliant, brother.
Get my talent, get money out of time. My chemical imbalance, who I go for in every line. What's the LB? What's the LB? When we dream and hear me, we do it live. All the ways and faces go. I'm feeling like I'm on the rooftop. So get this city alive. That's how you live in life. You dig it right. Get my heart and talent. Get money out of time. I keep the imbalance. Who I go for in every line. What's the LB? What's the LB?
What's the LB?
Yeah, tryna put my team on, so we got that sound good, my bass dope, maxed out to my levels tweaked. On stage, I'm on rage, got it up, I got no brain. Cobain on cocaine with no hair on, that's dope, man. Ride around like I'm bossing, double cup like I'm coughing. Ride around till I get it, I'm lying, who did it? Keep coming around like it's Christmas Eve, stay lit like a Christmas tree. All my papers, I'm pushing sleeves, I'm turned up, this shit geeks. Long man, she don't sleep off, and I'm living life, but you don't see. Swagged out in this pink dock, and my cup chilled at I'm skateboarding, so dope, I can't dance over. Dump my bags, then pull a stank on. When we dream and hear me, we do it live. All the race and bases go, I'm feeling like I'm on the rooftop, so blow the city lights. I'm living life, you dig it right. Get my own talent, get money out of time. My chemical imbalance, you walk over every line. What's the LB? What's the LB?
Saturated this life that we pursue. I must have made the right choice, cause now we making news. There's niggas making movies and my tracks is getting used. When we say we doing big things, it's probably not a ruse.
I guess that's why they play amused. Some niggas standing by don't see their ego getting loose. That's haters at my table, where's your neighbors in my shoes? It's time for making moves, I ain't asked to be excused.
In the boogie looking for the gold. Reach to my G's and I grab a couple stands. Get a couple more bottles, head to where my niggas at. We running this spot from the booking to the bed. So we came over, started dancing on my head. Feeling so fast like some pussy out the red.
I don't spend time on the haters and jealous. We spend a dime on the bullshit, what you selling me? Can't pay attention to the nonsense you're telling me. Even though I show you no love, you still feeling me. They doing shows, they putting me on the bed. They making movies, they putting me on bed. They dim the lights and the place goes dead. They finally listen to what I'm saying, it's so ill. For real, it's like everything I've been waiting for. It's grind time to double the buzz, making more. There's no quitting, it's hard, and I won't take a loss. It's feeling like my dreams is finally taking off. Yeah, I'm talking in flight material. My heart clubbing like Raw City, Imperial. Tokyo, London, Rio de Janeiro. It's not a test, it's the best, I'm just stereo.
Jumping all over the map, chilling in the clubs, sipping on some Henneken. Ladies walk by in the booty looking fresh. Raise to my G's and I grab a couple stars. Get a couple more bottles, check on where my niggas at. We running this spot from the bottom to the back. So we came over, started dancing on my lap. Feeling so fresh like some Gucci out the
back. We rolling. Yeah, South Coast, stupid shit, yeah.
that jealous rage will handle you, then rip apart your efforts and dismantle you. It's kinda similar when last with the rainbows run out, no illumination on your path, the darkness damage you. Ain't nowhere to run, ain't nowhere to hide. When the evil you try, escape and lives inside. But if you wanna ride and keep a clear mind, it's all good, it's a road of evil, that's where you reside. So I'm fucking out, they ain't got shit for me. They talk a big game, they ain't got shit on me. Take my hands up, I'm flying high. Ain't no sense in looking down when you're in the sky. Where do you go to escape from this place?
Chop it up, you know, put some bass in there, we'll make it pop off.
I gotta find some inspiration.
Okay. Then make a couple phone calls.
Yeah. Haha, Fresco. Diamond in the back, shit, chain around the neck. Take a new money check, give me my respect. Clean with some rockets on, rennies on the drop. Diamonds in the necklace, diamonds in the watch. Throw the cash up, make it rain in the club. Went fresh at the spot, everybody show me love. Living life good, still in the hood. Still get respect just like a nigga should. Still stuntin' right in front of haters cause I could. Still got beside of me, wish a nigga would. Cause I'm the cocky and you can't stop me though. Y'all niggas ain't ready like the Nazi fro. They call me Fresco, the next in the O. And if you ain't know, you best to just
slow down, slow down.
Game with some purpose side and a thick rib. Shorty that can work a thigh. She make it clap to the beat. Tap, tap on the beat. I can hear
Cigarette in my hands, black, black, trying to be I'm Mr. Mental, rock how I'm mental. Better take notes, boy, I move for your pencil. Streets is suspenseful, smooth with the mental. Always on point, young fool, shit you can't do. Can't hold a candle, that heat that I read you. Empty the when they put it on the mental. I can tell the thriller, kill a murder on his table. Everybody bounce in the beat and trance you. We going in and you can't ignore it. It's a lucid groove, homie, I'm all for it. They call me Fresco, next in the O. And if you ain't know, you best to just
slow down.
Slow down. Can't ride yours, y'all moving too slow. Got the pedal to the floor. Riding with my dogs, and niggas about four. Giving y'all the shit you can't find no more. So, see you can find it's a full-time grind. The 12 of my lines, you find 24 rhymes. Fresh, keep them impressed at all times. Got my right hand, man, the rest is all dimes. Yes, you know I don't play no games. And I've been blessed with impeccable aim, I maintain. Fresh, had to say the name, it's a game. Cause a little repetition keeps steady on the brain. We making moves to the top, we go. Y'all best to get ready like Rapido. It's J Fresco, next in the O. And if you ain't know, y'all best to just
slow down, slow down.
Saw my Helen and Troy, she entranced me with her eyes through a spelling book. We was about to run a 5-on-5. I had to put it on pause, cause shorty bad, I'm trying to get in the drawers. She got out of whip slowly, she seen me approach and got to smiling. Cause she knew she had a nigga open. Introductions made her lay a kiss on the hand. My homeboys get the clown and pop and shit to the mirrors, it's all good. Shorty let me know she impressed. Grabbed a hold of my hand and said, walk with me, brush. Now we walking and talking, she get to telling me that she got a man, but she swear she feeling me. No stress, and I don't ask what his name is. I figure he your name, kid, and now you ready, game this girl. I wasn't trying to change the world, just give her injections, sublime erections. I give her the number, not expecting the call. To my surprise, she hit me the same night. I run quick to get a bottle, get it popping at the crib. Break up some bug, cause I got a couple L's to twist. When shorty got to the crib, she looked so amazing. Walked in like it was her house, she started blazing. Rocking a black dress, pumps.
Robin Lynn.
Split down the back to the crack of her ass. Hair in the bun look damn near professional. Started telling me shit like we in a confessional. It's kinda hard, I don't usually find this. For 2.5 more hours we had mind sex. Mind connected till she run for the door. I run to stop a light, shorty, what you fighting it for? She say it only take a minute to fall. Head over heels and the way that she feel, it's a little too ill. I felt the same, yo, it actually threw me. Situations like this only happen in movies. The next scene to show me deep in the booty. But we exit out the story cause shorty she ain't a OG. Now here's the part where the turning point start. A ringtone blaring told me in my dream apart. Shorty snoring, now I hear it ignoring. 10 seconds ringing off the hook once more. Now I'm extra aggy when it's early in the day. About to chuck shorty's phone for a peep display. Got the tripping when I seen what it say. This nigga push from Flatbush. He known for turning niggas to mush. This is not your average nigga, hard body to the core. I almost contemplated kicking shorty out the door. Fucking with his bird, I just declared war. Want it all honesty, I ain't prepared for. Shorty grabs the phone, she start to pretend like she was up late night, getting drunk with her friends. And she was oh so concerned about scratching the fence. She spent the night over there with them.
Right.
This nigga slick, he said, alright, miss three way. Started calling her friend Crib to see what she say. Shorty praying that she don't pick up. She heard it low and got the trippin' like, damn, we fuck. Cause the story ain't fit, the GPS equipped. Whip shorty drive, told the nigga in a split. Second where we was, now we coming with the quick alert. The whole clique, shit's about to get thick, grip. Burners and clips, two for each hit. Bring out the diesel shits to make the street eclipse when it's ringing. And please, I need it with the swift. It's more than 10 minutes, I'ma need you to assist. Don't forget the extra clips, then click, check my supplies. Jam the elevator, now they got a ground five. Shorty's for the hip to me, load up the weaponry. Pause, shorty start flipping out next to me. Try to handle shorty with ease, she wanna leave. I say bounce if you want, but she met with me. Is this love, is it lust, is it real enough for us to get into this predicament, the bubble for bust? I never bleed from a nigga that bleed the same way I bleed, the same way I breathe is in his lungs. When he come, girl, you safer with me. You wanna run where I'm from, we don't play that. I shouldn't have to say that. I paint a picture for ya, the words is like a rush. The lyrics and the flow is the color, the right touch. I make a masterpiece out of easel, call it my venue. For this one here though, it gotta be continued.
Dreams, what a wonderful life. Ooh. making moves on the daily. And my attitude is fuck you, baby. Making moves on the daily. I ain't got time for people acting shady. Making moves on the daily. And my attitude is fuck you, baby. You don't want some real soldiers getting crazy. Yo, you know this life is amazing. I get it poppin' like an automatic. I'm coming all the way live. I see something and I gotta have it. Ain't a chance that you're taking mine. Oh, yeah, I'm moving on to big things. And I shine so bright. Yeah, made it from some big dreams. What a wonderful life. Oh, oh.
You for choosing the SNL Fan Podcast, and I'm your host, just some guy named Jay, like I've always been. And in this installment of the SNL Fan Podcast, what we're doing is, we have a guest on the show, and that guest is Nika Williams. Nika Williams is one half of the Mother Funny Quickies, and actually I had both Mother Funny Quickies on my list of 24 black comedians that should be on SNL right now. And you should definitely check out that list here on Too Good For Radio. And also check out this interview. But before I even get into the interview, I want to give a shout out. I want to give a shout out to South Coast Records. South Coast Records is a large independent record company, hip-hop based record company, based in Florida, which is where Nika Williams is also from as well. And they're doing big things. They have an artist on the label by the name of Jay Fresco. And Jay Fresco recently, well, he actually dropped his album, The Product, Volume 1, today. And I'm going to put the links in the information box below so you can check that out. And I'm also going to put links to the label on there so you can check out their music. Again, that's South Coast Records. And they're based in Florida, but they have artists all over the United States. So definitely check them out. They got some hot music. And, all right, enough about that. Let's get into this interview with Nika Williams. All right, this is Just Some Guy Named Jay, and I'm in a spot with Nika Williams. How you doing, Nika Williams?
Just a blessing. What's up with you, Jay? What's going on?
Oh, just hanging in there.
That's right. Keep it warm?
Oh, yeah, just trying to keep warm during this winter.
I know. Over in L.A. right now, it's kind of cold, but I'm not complaining because I could be in New York right now, so... I'm definitely grateful that the weather is, you know, not too cold.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. You know, that's great. now, see, you have a lot on the resume. You've been in 51st Dates, VH1's Best Week Ever, Stevie TV, Two Broke Girls, Hannah Montana, Modern Family, First Family, Snoop Dogg Presents, Bad Girls of Comedy, you know, the list just goes on.
Wow.
I'm blessed.
Right now, I'm actually, you know, it's the holidays, so it's kind of slow right now, but I actually just found out one of my shows got picked up by Centric TV.
Oh.
It's called According to Him and Her. It's a relationship show hosted by Barney Jordan and Finesse Mitchell. So that airs in January, so I'm super excited about that.
Oh, okay, okay. So what have you been doing on the show? Is it just, you just...
It's like a talking head format. A lot of the stuff I do... for VH1, kind of granted me this opportunity to be a part of According to Him and Her. But it's basically talking about relationships according to the women and men. And yeah, it's actually a really, really funny show, too, because you have a lot of different perspectives that clash, and people just kind of put it all out there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I can imagine. now, what inspired you to want to get into stand-up comedy in the first place?
What inspired me to be a comedian? Because I'm a damn fool. I've always had a had this innate ability to make people laugh. I'm the class clown. You know, it comes natural for me.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I see. You know.
Oh, it's supposed to come. I'm a
D-fool. Oh, well, you know, we can get away with that. That's a cool one to get away with. You know,
that's a cool curse word. Okay,
yeah,
okay,
you know.
Cool.
Cool. That's not going to mess up the AdSense. Yeah. Oh, yeah, congratulations on the show, too, by the way. I didn't say it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Now you're also a model, too, right?
Yeah, that was something that kind of... I had no choice in that because I'm 5'10", and I've been in height since I was like 7 years old, you know, just tall for no reason. So it helps that in this industry I'm able to model, do my comedy, and also I use my modeling experiences as my material. So that helps, you know. And it's not something that I actively pursue, but hey, if somebody calls me and say, you want to model in this fashion show, I'm not going to turn it down.
Oh, yeah.
It's okay.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, everybody needs some money, you know.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Oh yeah. Now, other than you being a damn fool, how would you describe yourself as a performer?
I would describe my comedy as very uninhibited, raw, eccentric, but at the same time relatable. You know, I'm just being me. When I'm on stage, that's the one medium I could just speak up. You know, I don't have to worry about what an exec has to say or what a writer has to say on a page. This is all me. So when I'm on stage, I feel completely free. So stand-up comedy for me is like, it's my passion. I will do that for free. And I have, believe me. So stand-up comedy, I mean, that's my passion amongst all things.
Now, how long have you been doing stand-up comedy?
I've been doing stand-up for about 10 years.
Ah.
For about 10 years, and I still haven't perfected it. You know, it's one of those things that say it takes 10 years to make it. Hmm. Well, I'm still on my making it phase. But, yeah, I've been doing it for almost 10 years. Wow, I realize that. Yeah.
Definitely. Now, what advice would you give to... anybody interested in becoming a stand-up comedian or getting into that?
I would tell people who want to be a comedian, don't do it. Don't. Just go do something else with your life. You're never going to get paid the money you want.
So you can take all
It's a hard road, you know? And me being a female, doing comedy, not easy. It's as if a female rapper trying to break into the game. It's so male-dominated. You have to really, really, really want it. And if it's not something that you really want, then you're not going to strive to get there. Because you got to write, you got to go to open mics, you got to try to get stayed on time, you got to try to, rub shoulders with other comedians to try to get them in, to put you on. So it's a never-ending process.
Oh, yeah. So, about, like you said, the open mics and things like that. So, do you still just do it just to test out new material or, kind of keep yourself warm and things like that?
Oh, yeah. Once you do a joke on TV, like, people don't want to hear that joke again.
Yeah.
It's kind of like you bump that material. So, you can't really go back to it. I have some staple jokes that I always do. But open mics for me just to keep me fresh. And to also, every day I have a different experience. So, of course, I want to talk about it. If I'm dating a dude with his breath smell nice, I want to talk about it. I want to get on stage and be like, this dude just farted out of his mouth. And, I just talk about that. So, open mic, I can get up 3-4 open mics in one night. And that joke can literally keep evolving. Every time I'm on stage, I add something, I take away something. So, yeah, open mics are very... pertinent when you're developing new material.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. And and I've checked out your stand-up too, of course on the internet. And a few of my favorite jokes from you is the one about Tyra Banks, the one just standing in place. That's the same pose. What you mean? and the other joke I like is when you talked about your father, you doing math with him. He's teaching you how to do math.
Those are jokes that they kind of define my brand. you know, I talk a lot about my dad, I talk a lot about my mom, I talk about my family, I have a big family, it's 6 of us, I have 10 nieces and nephews, so that's a lot of material. So I just use my everyday experiences and my family really as my set when I go on stage, which they don't like, but hey, once they get the money they
probably get to get mine. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. And you grew up in Florida, right?
Miami, baby, 305, Dade County, Rick Ross.
Ah. So, is all your family still out there, right?
Oh, yeah, all my family's in Miami.
Oh, okay. So, you often, when you do visit your family, you still, you hit up the open mics in those areas as well, or?
Oh, yeah, because, you know, when you're in L.A., it's so saturated with artists and comedians and writers and actors, but when I go home, it's just a break from all the business stuff. So, of course, I go home, I perform, and people love it. It's like home team, you know, you're making it. And then they don't know that it's everyday struggle, but in their mind, hey, I've actually made it because I've pursued my dream. So, I love going home. It's just like I get reinvigorated when I go home. So, when I come back to LA, you know, I hustle even harder.
Sorry. Can't
say that.
Oh, you're good. now, you know, this is the SNL fan podcast, and you know, I had you on the list of 24 black comedians that should be on SNL right now. And now, are you a fan of SNL or a casual fan or?
Well, you know, SNL is a staple in the comedy world, and you know, I grew up actually watching that TV and in Living Color. Those two sketch shows for me were like Fire Marshal Bill, you know, those characters for me, both are close to my heart. But SNL, of course, I've watched and enjoyed, you know, shows that they put out. But the whole controversy with Keenan saying black women weren't ready, it wasn't a positive thing, but it actually helped in getting the word out that, hey, we as a black woman need to be represented in the comedy world.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I wrote and directed the We Are Ready skit that featured 11 comedians performing original characters, celebrities, impressions, just to show them, like, hey, we are ready. And for COVID, here's a skit. So we were excited. We jumped on it. Me and my girl, Michelle, which is my partner and writing partner for Mother Funny Quickies, we got 11 people together. We wanted more. We reached out to everybody we knew, but we basically, you know, came up with about 11 people, and we put that sketch out, and it did really well on the internet and still continues to do well. So we're happy about that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And also about more than half the people that you had in the We Are Ready skit are on my list as well. Now, what made you decide to go after those people? Well, I guess you were just getting as many black female comedians as you could, but why some of those though?
Well, these are personal friends of mine, and these are also a database of funny females. And people don't realize in the sketch community, it's very small. You know who do sketch, you know who do stand up. So, you know, I literally had to just go to my phone and send a text like, hey, are you available today? Can you shoot? Can you write? Can you get your cast together? And boom, you know, we were shooting literally the next couple of days. So the circle is small. It really is small. That's why I'm kind of like, are you really looking for black female comedians? Because they're out there and they are ready, you know?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And, you know, when Keenan said that about black female not being ready, you know, I mean, it's not like I know exactly, you know, like what he really meant by that. But, okay, what I'm trying to say is, I don't think he necessarily, and from my opinion, meant to be spiteful. I mean, you know, it was kind of messed up he said it. But I think it's kind of one of those things, like, when you just don't know any better, you kind of say stuff like that. And because he could have also meant like maybe the ones that they've had just, I mean, maybe the ones they had auditioned just weren't ready. And also too, I also noticed like some of these women might say something like, well, I'm already in Los Angeles and my husband has a good job out here. I don't want to move the family or you know, this and that. I have this situation going on. That's also what he could mean by
that. When you get that call, I don't care if you're in Timbuktu. You're going to go and take advantage of that opportunity because that may not happen again. Yeah. So even though someone may be in LA, and I know SNL shoots in New York, I mean, let's keep it real. We have to move, and we have to take advantage of those opportunities, even if that means uprooting your family and moving across country. And SNL is just another platform for a comedian. It's not the end all to be all. You know, you have other things a person can do, but let's keep it real. SNL is also a comedy giant. So to get on that show, it will totally propel your career to the next level.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. And, you know, it ain't okay to say what you say. Could you picture yourself building with him and working with him if you were on SNL?
Listen, as long as my check clears, I can work with anybody, okay? It's called show business, not show friendliness.
Yes,
okay?
Amen.
Somebody,
because
guess what? In this business, people have different personalities. People have different perspectives. And you don't have to personalize that. You go to work, you do your job, and... You know, you stay professional. So, yeah, I don't have to talk. Hey,
Tishnit,
SNL, Lauren Michael, call me. I'm
ready. Sure. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And you're ready. Now, you've also worked with a lot of SNL people from the past, like Taryn Killam, Garrett Morris, Tim Meadows, Adam Sandler, and now Finesse Mitchell. How was it like working with some of those people? You got any stories, anything about working with any of those?
Garrett Morris, I actually just worked with him recently on Two Broke Girls, and he is just the sweetest, most encouraging person. I just remember them saying, you keep doing what you're doing. You keep going after this comedy thing. And, I mean, for that time, I was struggling. I was, like, mentally, like, literally trying to keep it together. And when I did the show, those words, I just kept hearing him in the back of my mind. Like, I'm going to keep going. Because he, I mean, look, he's been in the game for a minute.
Oh, yeah.
I'm doing it. So, you know, you gotta be the testament that you don't stop, keep going. So, yeah, Garrett Morris, and he's hilarious, too. So, yeah, I would have to say, you know, out of all those list of people, he definitely at the top of the list for me.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Now, damn, I lost my train of thought. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. John Goodman is hosting SNL this upcoming weekend. Now, if you were on SNL right now, what would you pitch in the writer's room to John Goodman?
What I would pitch to John Goodman? I would totally pitch. I love playing characters that's just far out there. And he played a character in Denzel just did Flight, but he's like this hippie, drug hippie. So I would pitch to him, let's do a sketch about two drug hippies, you know, from the 70s, kind of pop mouth and all that, and I would totally want to do that character with him because he is the consummate comedian. When you think about comedians, this guy is a beast.
Oh,
so yeah, I would definitely pitch those characters to him.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. Definitely. I also want to go back to Garrett Moore for a second. Now, did you watch a lot of the 70s ones when he was in the cast? You know, with Gilda Radner and Chevy Chase and all them? Because he was great on Martin.
Oh yeah,
he's
the best Martin.
Now let's talk about the MF Quickies for a sec. Now what brought you and Lachey together to do this?
Lachey and I actually used to be a part of a sketch group called Cleo's Apartment. That was our first sketch group together, and then we went on to be a part of EDF3 with Nefertari and Angela and Indira and Nakia. So I've been working with Lachey for almost 10 years. And we decided, hey, let's create our own sketch group, our own comedy duo. And we were racking our brains, trying to figure out what we wanted to do, what we wanted to be called, and we came up with Mother Funny Quickies. So that's basically how we got started. We worked together for almost 10 years. So it was just natural for us to come together and do something as a comedy duo.
Ah, okay, okay.
Yeah.
Now about the Elite Delta, because I know you were on, like I said, the Elite Delta Force with Nefertari and all that. in the recent sketches I've seen, I noticed you're not in them. Is there a particular reason or?
Well, you know, I can't be talking about, you know, my agent said, you know, stay away from controversy. You know? Well, at one point I went to do my own solo one person show, the Nika Project, and so I was absent from the group for a while. But you know, I'm still a part of PDF3. That's never going to change. You know, we started that group together, all of us. And this was back before the whole SNL controversy. We created an all-female black sketch group. So it's just kind of ironic that now it's kind of an issue. But we were all already tackling that issue back then. I mean, performing live shows at Iowa West and performing at the BBC West with Vanessa Bell Calloway. Mm. So we've been, you know, we're ahead of the curve. We're just waiting for everybody else to catch up.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And they definitely will, too, you know. Because, I mean, you can't deny just true talent and just being funny, you know.
Can't deny it.
Exactly. Now, I see you had a Melanie Mosley in the sketch as well. And I recently had Melanie Mosley on the show. You plan on doing anything else with Melanie Mosley? I also see you were in tracks with her, too.
Yes. I actually played a trackhead, a crackhead in tracks, for short. Produced and written by Simone Shepherd,
mm-hmm.
also very funny black female comedian. Melanie is hilarious. I mean, Melanie is like, she goes for it, which I absolutely love. So yeah, I'm definitely hoping to work with her in the near future.
Oh yeah, definitely, definitely. Now, speaking of the future, anything that you and Lachey plan on doing in 2014 as far as sketches, any kind of ideas, or you kind of just, or y'all kind of just go as you go? How does that work?
Oh no! It's time to everything that's happened. We're hopefully motivated to do bigger and better things. So we're actually coming out with our season 3 right now. We're writing, pitching ideas, and it's just us two. So we literally go back and forth to different ideas, and we have some funny stuff that we're writing and pitching right now. So yeah, season 3, like we just did the We Are Ready. The Scandal Spoof, which is hilarious.
Robin Lynn.
And I'm playing Huck and a couple other characters. So this is just our thing. Sometimes we have a run and gun process where we just come up with an idea and we just run and gun and shoot it. But now we're taking a little more time to write and to really perfect the sketches. So yeah, season 3 is going to be a banger. We're definitely looking forward to that.
Alright. Now I'm going to ask a controversial question. You know.
Okay.
Who's funnier, you or Lachey?
Who's funnier?
Yeah.
I know you did. You know what? We both have very different styles of comedy. You know, I'm a stand-up comedian. I do stand-up, and we both have a sketch background. But I think we're both funny in our own right. So, you know, I don't think there's who's funny or not. I mean, I'll leave that up to the people. And believe me, they don't hold back on YouTube. They let us know if it's lag, they let us know if it's funny, and that's fine. Like, you know, I'm not tripping on that because just like I have to receive the good, I also have to receive the bad. And it just motivates me to do even better. You know what I mean? If you think I'm lag, I'm going to try to convince you that this is going to be funny. This is going to blow your head off. And if it doesn't, guess what? You probably whack. So, yeah. We don't do that. We just stay in, like I said, we stay in our lane, and we just keep it pushing.
Oh, yeah, and the chemistry between both. Oh, yeah. And the chemistry between both of y'all, it's like glue. You know, it's just perfect. You know?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Also, before we wrap this up, I want to get some drops and stuff from you, but before I do, I want to ask, is there anything you want to plug, any shout-outs, anything you want to mention that's coming up in 2014, aside from the you know, the show Finesse, or anything else?
Well, I just
want to
say, you know, I have a YouTube channel, Nika, N-I-K-A, Will, W-I-L-L, #1. Also, check me out on Facebook and Twitter. My handle is @Nika, NIKAWILL. And yeah, 2014 is going to be a great year. I'm looking forward to new projects. I'm actually a finalist in the comedy the Shaq Comedy Tour contest.
Oh.
So we're actually having the finals in the first of the year, so I'm looking forward to that. But yeah, you know, it's just, it's all about Nika Williams. It's definitely Motherfucking Quickies also season 3 coming out. So got a lot on my plate, but I'm happy to be doing what I love.
Oh yeah, and also too, if you have anything in the future you want to plug, anytime you want to just get back on the podcast and talk about some more things, test out some new material, anything, you're always welcome. Always, just, you know, keep blessing me with links and anything. Just definitely, you know, I'm a fan, and I'll definitely keep my listeners updated too. You know,
that's what's up. We gotta push forward together.
Oh, yeah.
You want to make a dream work, right?
Definitely, definitely. All right, now hold on. I'm going to wrap this up, but I want to get some drops and things from you right quick, too.
Okay.
All right, so you've been listening to the SNL Fan Podcast. It's just some guy named Jay with Nika Williams, and that's news to me.